Hey, welcome back to Natural News from the Field Museum. We have some spooky stories in today's episode. New research on a few of Madagascar's adorable bacterial disease-carrying critters, a shout-out to our volunteers in the Bird Prep Lab, and a scary story about how a ghost from science past continues to haunt our researchers today. Let's get to it. Tailless Tenrecs, cute little disease reservoirs. Tenrecs are funny little mammals. They look sort of like a mashup between a shrew, an opossum, and a hedgehog. Some of them even have quills. There are a number of species throughout Africa and the island of Madagascar, and recently one of these, the tailless tenrec, was discovered by field biologist Steve Goodman and his collaborators to be adorable reservoirs for disease. Tailless tenrecs are native to Madagascar, but have been introduced to Mayotte, an island that's part of the Comoros archipelago. And with them, they've brought Leptospira meotensis, which is a bacterial disease that can be transmitted from animals to humans. The illness the bacteria causes is called leptospirosis, and it's passed on to humans through contact with contaminated urine, blood, or water, soil, or food from infected hosts, making it bad news for farmers and those that work with animals. Contracting the disease doesn't come without some potentially major consequences. While some infected people may not exhibit any symptoms, others can experience fever, headache, vomiting, even liver failure or meningitis, and death. While it was known to come from certain livestock animals like cattle and pigs, Steve and his colleagues report in a recent PLOS paper that the tailless tenrec also carries the bacteria along with dogs and rats. So ultimately, knowing how different species of the leptospirobacteria travel between wild animals, livestock, and humans can help healthcare professionals and medical researchers diagnose and treat the disease. The good news is that the Centers for Disease Control recommends limiting your time swimming or wading in water that's contaminated with animal urine, and you greatly reduce your risk for exposure. So, yeah, don't swim in pee. Got it. I'm going to tell you this spooky story about a scientist who took incomplete notes. Dr. Elias Francis Shipman was a student at Northwestern University Preparatory School in 1872 when he became interested in natural history, specifically botany. But on one collecting trip in northwestern Indiana near his home, he snagged another find, the Hoosier frog, a new and rare species. The find was published 6 years later in the 1878 edition of the Manual of the Vertebrate Animals of the Northern United States, and his specimen went on to the Chicago Academy of Sciences. But there was a mystery to solve. Where and when exactly did Shipman find the frog? The only clue he left was a single name, Benton County, Indiana. Collections manager of reptiles and amphibians Allen and co-author Donna Resetar detail in their recent paper Dr. Elias Francis Shipman and the Hoosier frog how they combed through records from the herbarium to try and pinpoint the specimen's origins. They tracked his movements based off of digitized school newspapers and dates on the plants he collected as a student. Allen and Donna narrowed down a year, 1876. During the process, they revealed that Shipman enjoyed going by the name Shippy, and he excelled at intramural sports. While these details didn't really help pinpoint the frog's location, they were kind of fun to learn anyway. Unfortunately, Shippy passed away not long after graduation. There's no record of his death, and his original tombstone has worn away, replaced by one with inaccurate information, leaving his legacy with even more questions to answer. Perhaps Shippy's ghost still wanders Benton County in search of other specimens of the Hoosier frog, reminding young students, record exact collecting coordinates, invest in global positioning systems, or you will be haunted by scientists from the past. It's Wednesday. That must mean a few dozen people are here pulling apart dead birds for science. The Chicago Tribune came by the bird collection to highlight one of the cooler but smellier activities some museum volunteers get to participate in, bird prep. Every year, some 6,000 to 7,000 new birds are donated to the museum by a group called the Chicago Bird Collision Monitors. Throughout the year, volunteers from the CBCM pick up any birds that are injured or die as a result of flying into our downtown skyscrapers. The injured birds are taken to a wildlife rehab center, and the dead ones end up here at the museum. Each one of these birds is accompanied with information about when and where it was found, then goes into a freezer to kill off any hitchhiking parasites or pests. Before the bird is prepped, the parasites are collected and stored in vials, the bird is weighed, and it either becomes a study skin or is skeletonized by our flesh-eating beetles. But first, a portion of its tissue is preserved in a tube and cryogenically frozen for future DNA analysis because, after all, this is the future we live in. In the last 30 years, our museum has received more than 75,000 birds that have died from window strike alone. In a single square mile in downtown Chicago, more than 170 different species have been recovered. There's a ton of information that can be learned from them, like the weeks the migrations are occurring and how that changes from year to year as effects from climate change impact temperature and food availability. And researchers from all over the world use the birds to answer questions about everything from how the age can be learned by studying a bird's plumage to the type of pathogens and parasites found on them and how they may be transmitted between birds and perhaps to humans. Regardless of what the specimens are used for, it's great to have a team of volunteers who help them along to meet their research potential. If you're into this kind of thing, be sure to check in your area for any museums that might be interested in taking birds for their collections, too. With the right permits, you, too, can be tasked with telling passerbys that the dead bird in your hand is destined for science. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Natural News from the Field Museum. If you guys are interested in the things we talked about, we included links to articles in the description that you should check out, and make sure you subscribe so you can get a notification every time we post another video, like the next episode of Natural News, coming out in 2 weeks. See ya. It smells like knowledge.